Over now to the upcoming midterm polls. 66 out of 183 senatorial aspirants were included in the partial list of candidates of the Commission on Elections for the 2025 polls. The list includes names from political families, including former Interior Chief Benhur Abalos, Makati Mayor Abby Binay, and House lawmaker Camille Villar. Re-electionists, including Bong Revilla, Pia Cayetano, Ronald De La Rosa, and Bongo, also made the list. Also included are TV host Willie Revillame, actor Philip Salvador, and singer-lawyer Jimmy Bondoc. The current number of candidates is more than 54 who vied for seats in the 2022 elections. 117 aspirants did not make the cut. Detained preacher and self-proclaimed son of God Apollo Kibuloy also making it to the partial list of senatorial candidates. But a labor leader seeking to stop Kibuloy's name from making it to the ballot. Senatorial aspirant Sonny Matula filed a petition with the Commission on Elections to cancel the candidacy of the detained preacher. Kibuloy was supposedly running under the banner of the Workers and Peasants Party, or WPP, where Matula is a candidate. In his petition, Matula asserts Kibuloy was never a member of their party. The camp of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ leader, meanwhile, hits back. It asked COMELEC to declare Matula and nine other aspirants to nuisance candidates. The pastor's lawyer, attorney Mark Tolentino, earlier revealed there was a faction in the party insisting Matula's group, called Workers' Party Philippines, is not legitimate. The chief architect of the Duterte administration's drug war eyeing to hold a Senate inquiry into the deadly campaign. Senator Ronald De La Rosa says he will even invite his former boss to the investigation. Vivian Gulia reports.
In a manner of speaking, Mr. President,
a senator who once led the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs wants a parallel Senate investigation into the matter. Senator Ronald De La Rosa says this will counter the House of Representatives' Quad Committee hearings, where he, his former boss, former President Rodrigo Duterte, and ally Senator Bongo were implicated in an alleged reward system for cops who would kill drug suspects. Former police officer and PCSO general manager Royina Garma said the reward could go up to as high as 1 million pesos, depending on the drug personality. Both Go and De La Rosa have denied the existence of the alleged financial incentive.
May check and balance din. May nakikita man din siguro si Senator Bongo na mag-portion ng investigation doon na talagang na false accusations na tinatanggap ng Quadcom as hook, line, and sinker, as good gospel truth. Magiging fair yung investigation.
De La Rosa says he has not spoken to Duterte but believes he would be more willing to face the Senate than the House.
Malaking posibilidad na mag-attend siya kung kami mag-imbita kasi mas komportable siya dito sa Senado kaysa Lower House.
In a statement, Senate President Pro Tempore Jinggoy Estrada said Duterte's attendance in the planned hearings is essential for justice and transparency in the Senate inquiry. De La Rosa said his committee can initiate the hearing on its own, but a resolution that Go plans to file could also initiate the Senate's own investigation into the drug war killings. De La Rosa says the hearings could be done while Congress is on break. House Quad Committee co-chairperson and Manila City 6th District Representative Bienvenido Abante Jr. said he welcomes a parallel Senate probe into the Duterte drug war, but he does not expect an objective inquiry.
Just imagine, he was only a brigadier general all of a sudden. Nagtagdagan siya ng star, no? Naging major general siya and naging director general. So I would think that he would be more biased than actually balanced in that hearing. No?
ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro also questions the objectivity of the proposed Senate investigation, which she sees as a possible diversion from the Quadcom probe. Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel, meanwhile, reminds senators that congressional investigations should not be used to shield those involved in what he called fake war on drugs. He says such inquiries should be in aid of legislation and not in aid of self-preservation. A similar call was made by former Senator Leila De Lima, a staunch Duterte critic who endured 7 years in prison in what many called as trumped-up drug charges.
Sana yung mga nasasangkot, sila Senator Bato, sila Senator Bongo, ay wag naman nilang gamitin yung posisyon nila o status nila dyan sa Senado para for example mang braso. Di ba kailangan ay maging bukas ang kanilang isipan na maging objective sila sa pag-handle ng ganyang investigasyon.
The House Quad Committee meanwhile plans to tap the Anti-Money Laundering Council in tracking the cash flow of the alleged reward system in Duterte's drug war as it investigates whether intelligence funds from the Office of the President was used as reward.
At tatanungin namin yung AMLA tungkol sa paglipat-lipat ng perang yan, kung saan nanggaling yan, kung saan napunta yan, kung sino ang nag-spend yan.
It was not used as reward money. Talagang intel operations ang ginagamitan ng intel fund na yan.
The Quadcom will resume its hearing on October 22. Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin, for his part, said the reopening of investigations into high-profile killings related to the war on drugs should indicate that the Marcos administration places the highest importance on the fair dispensation of justice and on the universal observance of the rule of law in the country. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
17 Chinese nationals nabbed in a resort in Tagaytay where alleged offshore gaming operations were taking place. Authorities found various gadgets believed to have been used in cryptocurrency scams. The National Bureau of Investigation raided the property after receiving a tip from a supposed Chinese torture victim.
Gusto nang kumalas. Kaya ayun, binubugbog. Kinukuryente. Yun ang na-rescue. Okay. Magpapail siya ng complaint.
Ano ba yung mga ginagawa
niya? Isa lang siya, sir, na ano?
Siya lang, yung isa na nirescue namin.
The village chief says they have been suspicious of the report after it suddenly became off limits. The resort's operations now suspended following the raid.
Tuwing dadaan ng December, dito kami nag-Christmas party. Pero wala pa po yung mga yan. Saka nung July 12, dito po ako na venue sa Tapat na resort. Ay yan ay wala pa po dito. Ay naupa ang mga yan. Pinapuntahan ko sa aking mga utility. Ayaw sila papasukin. Kasi private property po ito. Alang namin pasukin.
Meanwhile, after the October 15 deadline, the Immigration Bureau says 12,000 foreign POGO workers have already downgraded their working visas. Those who did not comply will be deported or blacklisted. Diplomats of the Philippines and China meet in Beijing on the heels of a recent encounter of the two countries' ship in the West Philippine Sea. Beijing's Foreign Affairs Ministry did not disclose details of the meeting between its Vice Minister Chen Xiaodong and members of the Philippine Council on Foreign Relations. It merely said the talk centered on maritime issues. The meeting was held days after a Chinese maritime militia vessel sideswept a Philippine Fisheries Bureau ship that was on patrol near Pagasa Island. The Philippines set to host a board meeting on the loss and damage fund in December. The country's environment chief hopes to reach certain agreements, such as funding sources and which climate-vulnerable countries will be able to avail the fund. Secretary Maria Antonia Yulo Loizaga says funding so far is at less than $700 million, which will be used to set up the operations of the fund.
Countries like Kiribati, Vanuatu, their conditions are far more extreme than dito po sa atin, no? Siyempre po, we don't diminish kung ano po nangyayari dito sa atin ngayon in terms of baha. Pero sa kanila po, wala pong kasanggang bundok or whatever sa kanila, no? They are exposed, they are vulnerable, their cultures are also being threatened. We are not managing the fund themselves. Alam niyo naman, the arrangement has been that for the meantime, the World Bank will be the repository of the fund. However, the rules and guidelines for the availments will be the board, no? That will decide.
Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Good morning, Chanel.
Good morning, Bettina. Good morning to all. So currently, we are not monitoring any tropical cyclone or low pressure area within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. However, Intertropical Convergence Zone or ITCZ, which is currently affecting southern Mindanao, will bring cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorm over Zamboanga Peninsula, Davao Occidental, Sarangani, South Cotabato, Sultan Kudarat, Basilan, Sulu, Tawi-Tawi, and Palawan. From Metro Manila and the rest of our country, expect a warm and humid during the afternoon and early afternoon, and also expect a localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening. That's the latest news from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for the update, Chanel.